Hello everyone, I'm Corey Cooper, a DevRel manager at Circle. In this video, we're going to do a deep dive into USDC, its core principles, and how developers can harness its powerful smart contract functionality. By the end of this, you'll see how USDC is revolutionizing the transfer of money globally. Let's start with the foundational principles of USDC. At its core, USDC is anchored in transparency. Each token is a representation of a dollar. It's designed to operate seamlessly across multiple blockchains, ensuring a smooth experience. Above all, USDC is backed by robust security measures, which prioritizes user protection. Diving into the USDC token contract, there are five distinctive specifications that developers should be aware of. The allow or block list feature serves as safeguards, protecting users from transacting with potential bad actors. Next, spend on behalf streamlines transactions, letting one address spend USDC for another. Multi-sig transactions offer enhanced security by necessitating multiple sign-offs for crucial operations. Mintr configuration brings diversity to USDC issuance by permitting various trusted entities to issue token. Lastly, the pause or upgrade feature epitomizes adaptability, allowing for transaction pauses and seamless contract upgrades. With these foundational principles and standout specifications, USDC is more than a token. It's reshaping digital finance by combining ease of use and unmatched security. Now let's jump into Circle Smart Contract Platform. I'm going to give you an overview of all the functions that developers can use to transact with USDC over various public blockchains. So in this section of the video, I'm going to show you how you can log into Circle Smart Contract Platform, create a wallet address, import a USDC token contract, and then actually programmatically interact with it by performing a simple transfer of tokens. Let's log in to the Circle Developer console, the Web3 Services console. So I've already have an account, so I'm gonna log in. If you don't, you can click the sign up button and it'll walk you through a few steps and you'll be within the account within like 5 minutes. So we're logging in. And upon logging in, you'll be prompted to the home screen. The home screen will show you some interactive tutorials you can use to actually get started really quickly. Also, you can find our developer docs, read through the docs, and kind of understand how you should be forming your request and response shapes to be able to interact with our different APIs to generate wallets or interact with smart contracts. So we're focused on the smart contract side of things because this is a deep dive into the USDC token contract and how developers can access the functionality to actually move money around the globe instantly. So we're going to scroll down to the bottom left-hand corner of the screen on the sidebar. We're going to click on the smart contract section, right? And what we want to do is we want to import the USDC token contract into the platform so that it will allow us to gain access to all of the functionality via the smart contract platform API endpoints. What I'm going to do is I'm going to switch gears to the Circle website. We've got a circle.com/en/multichain-USDC site that shows a list of all of the chains that USDC has been deployed on and natively how you can interact with them on mainnet and testnet. So we're going to use Avalanche and this is testnet. So we're going to move a few dollars on testnet. So we're going to click on this testnet address. It's going to take us to the Snowtrace Block Explorer where it has all the information about the token contract. What's most important to us here is the actual contract address. We'll copy this address and then we'll switch back over to the developer console and we're going to import this. So we're going to call this USDC on Avalanche, AVAX for short, native USDC on AVAX testnet, Fuji testnet. That's where we're going to be playing around. We're going to select the network. So Avalanche Fuji, that's for the testnet network. And then we're going to copy that contract address that we pulled from the actual Block Explorer. We're going to copy it in here. And we're going to hit import. And what this is going to do is going to import all of the functionality of the token contract into this dashboard and show it in a human readable view. So we'll click on the contract that we just imported, and we can see that now we have this contract imported, and we can kind of read the ABI functions and the transactions. So it's pulling in all of the transaction activity that's happening on this contract. As you can see, there was a transfer that just happened a few minutes ago, whatever, on testnet. So it consumes all that information. And then you have your ABI functions, which show all of the functions that you can call. So it looks like here we need to import the originating contract so we can see all of the read and write functionality that developers have access to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the Block Explorer. I'm going to click on contracts, read as proxy, and I'm going to actually copy this address. This is the originating contract with all the ABI functionality that we were looking for. We're going to pull this in. So let's go back and let's do another import USDC. LC, so originating contract, AVAX, USDC, one, testnet, Avalanche, Fuji. We're gonna drop the originating contract, click import. Let's click on this. So now we have the functions, right, that we need to interact with. And as you can see, they're split out into two categories, read and write. We want to write because we're going to, you know, actually do a transfer call. So we'll scroll down, click on transfer, and it shows us the parameter values that we need to pass with a transfer call to actually move money. This is saying you need to pass the to address, so where you want to send the money. So what's the address, public address to that? And then the value, right? How much we want to send. And then here is a code snippet, right, that you can put in your application, and it allows you to easily grab this code snippet, drop it into your app, and you're up and running with interacting and transferring money. Let's switch gears to spinning up our Firebase cloud functions, because we want to use that so that we can actually show a demo transaction. So I want to really get into the meat of things here. So I'm create a new terminal, cam in my Firebase. So I need to run this emulator. Okay, so I've got my Firebase emulator running, right? And so these are a few different cloud functions that I've created so that I can actually interact with our smart contract platform API endpoint to programmatically move money. We're gonna create a wallet set ID, and then we're gonna create a wallet, and then we're going to top it up with some USDC in that wallet. And then what we're going to do is we're going to call the USDC token contract to perform a transfer. So let me get access to my functions. Let's see. That's not... Let's pull up the function logs. Okay. First function we want to call is the create dev wallet ID, and I'm going to open up the code so we can look at this. So this is the code for my cloud functions that I've set up, and we're going to create a wallet set first. So we're going to call this function right here, create dev wallet ID. So that's creating a wallet set ID. And then here you can kind of see the request. So it's post request and calling this and passing this information. So really all it needs is item potency key, a name, and the entity secret ciphertext, which is used to kind of protect your API endpoints and make sure you are the person who is in fact calling the call. We will go back to the terminal, create a new tab, and I'll make a curl request to make this call. All right, so we've got a response back. That's a good thing. It created a wallet set, as you can see, and that ID is start 018, ends with FFD. So let's go back to the dashboard. Let's see if it created that wallet set for us. Wallet. All right, I do not see the actual transaction. So let's give it some time. Let's look at the logs. All right, so we did make this call. It was 201, so it was successful. Post request, and it created a developer wallet set. I think what I need to do now is call, take this wallet set ID and then actually generate a wallet, and then it's going to show up. So let me take the wallet set ID. Let's go back to the code. And so now we're going to, you know, run this command that creates a dev wallet. So what we're going to need to do when we pass this is we need to pass the wallet set ID. So I'm going to plug this in, right? Save this. It should create a wallet on the Avalanche Fuji network and given it this name, test account via cloud function and this ref ID. So let me go back to the terminal and perform another curl request, right, with that and call that function. So create dev wallet is the function I'm calling. All right, got a successful response. This is the wallet ID. So I should see this information, this wallet, right? Should see this in my console now. So I'm gonna go back to the console and I'm going to refresh. All right, boom. So you see this is the Avalanche Fuji wallet that I just created. It's got the wallet set ID, the address. I wanna top this up with some tokens. I'm going to open up my MetaMask wallet. First, I'm gonna send it 0.1 AVAX tokens so I have enough gas tokens to perform the transaction that we're gonna programmatically do. And then I'm gonna send it some USDC. Let me copy this address, hit send, MetaMask. We're gonna send some gas tokens. So I'm gonna do 0.1 AVAX. Then I'm gonna send some USDC. Switch to USDC, so $10. All right. Hit confirm. I should see some funds show up in this wallet. So let's drill down the detail view. See my 0.1 AVAX tokens is deposited. In a few seconds, I should see the USDC. All right, $10 worth of USDC. It's here. Now we are going to show how I can call this contract and make a transfer call against this contract to programmatically use the smart contract to transfer USDC back to the actual MetaMask wallet. I'm going to go back to my cloud functions, scroll down to the contract dev execution function I created right here, right? I'm gonna call this function. And let's see the meat of it, what we're passing. So here's the post request that we're making, right? And so there's some important stuff that we're passing. Idempotency key again, the ciphertext for security purposes, and then the ABI function signature, right? We're calling that transfer function, and you remember the parameters we looked at earlier, the address and then the unsigned integer 256, that's the amount, right, that we want to send. So here's the wallet address, right, that are going to send USDC to from the new developer control wallet that we spun up. And then we're going to send $3 worth of USDC. As you can see, it's six decimal places. So this is $3. And then the contract that we're looking at to perform this transaction is the USDC token contract that we found here, right, on the multi-chain USDC website, right here, right? Then we want to send it at a medium speed. So we want the transaction to get there pretty quickly, willing to pay the gas. And then we need to put in our wallet ID, which is the source wallet that we're gonna use that has the USDC and AVAX tokens in it to perform this transaction. So we've got $10 of USDC in there, 0.1 AVAX tokens. We want to send that back to the MetaMask wallet. So let's go see how much we have in MetaMask right now, right? We've got $73 worth of USDC. I'm going to send $3, so we should have 76 when I call this smart contract. All right, so let's go to the wallets, right? And I need to get this wallet ID, right? So I'm gonna grab the wallet ID right here. And I am gonna go back to my script, place it in here, right? Save it. I'm gonna call this contract for a transfer call. All right. All right, so it's saying that transaction was initiated, right? You see it here? This is the ID. We can go back to our wallet. Let's look at transactions. We've got a outbound transaction, right? This is the one we sent. So that means we're withdrawing, right? That's why it's saying outbound. We're withdrawing USDC. And it's showing information about the transaction, right? If we wanted to, obviously the ABI method is showing it was a transfer, right? And it actually has a transaction hash here. So we can take this transaction hash code and look up this particular transaction on the Block Explorer right here. And so here you see that $3, remember it was $3 that I told you I was gonna programmatically send, it's there. And it's showing the from address, to address. So all the information about this transaction is here on the Block Explorer, which is like the source of truth for the blockchain transactions. And we can go back to our dashboard. We can look up that wallet. We should have $7 in that wallet, right? Let's click. Up. Oh, see, we've got seven because we sent three, right? So, and then we should be able to go open up our wallet here, $76. This is showing you the power of smart contracts in USDC and how developers literally can write code that can interact with the USDC protocol to move dollars across public blockchains without any intermediary financial institution involved. This is pure programmatic money, and there is exciting times now in the payment industry and in all of e-commerce with this type of innovation that developers can do. Thank you. Feel free to reach out to me on Twitter or LinkedIn and give us a like and share this content. Thank you.